What up, Work Pack? It's Jam TJ, the LPTA. So, you're a PTA now. You're a PT now. Or you've graduated, you've taken your test, or you haven't taken your test. You're thinking about what career you want to go into, or you're thinking about what setting you want to work in. Well, this video might help you, give you an idea. Let's get to work. Acute care hospital. Now, that's where I've worked. And it's the hospital you treat different diagnoses, whether it's total hips post-op, total shoulders, total knees, med-surg, oncology, ICU, NICU, medical ICU. What else? Joint center. That's pretty much the joint center we already talked about. But yes, in this setting, you see patients pretty much there. They're there until they get discharged, and they either go home, they either go to an outpatient, or they go into a rehab, a day rehab. Okay? So that's number one, acute care. Number two is the rehab. Now, rehab, this is a little bit more intense for the patient. They can actually receive therapy for up to 3 hours a day. And this is more intensive. They have to be a candidate in order to be prepared to go home or whatever setting they're gonna go to. So if they had a total hip or a total knee done and they're not ready to go home, the family's not ready for them to go home, they can actually go to day rehab and they can work with these fine therapists that are actually gonna get them stronger, do a lot of activities of daily living, do a lot of things that's gonna get them functional and stronger for them to walk around their house. They're going to sometimes assess how they get into in and out of a car. They teach them how to get in and out of a tub, a shower, in their house, if they have stairs, how many steps, you know, things of that nature that kind of helps them to understand what to expect when they're ready to go home. Okay, so that is rehab. Okay, number three, a skilled nursing facility. Okay. And that, you might have heard it called SNF, because that's the S-N-F, okay? Now, in this facility, this is kind of a long-term or short-term facility. It kind of depends on what the patient needs are, and the patients are actually going to be seen for various amount of times just to make sure that they're strong, they're doing functional things, they're able to do a lot of functional stuff like sit to standing, bed mobility, transfers to the toilet, transfers to the bath, and this kind of also helps them prepare to get home. This is kind of like rehab, but not as intense, depending on the population, because the population is mostly geriatric. So they help with a lot of things when it comes to skilled nursing, and it takes a little bit longer than the day rehab because of it being less intensive, and that's okay because it tends to the patient's needs. Okay, so number three is skilled nursing facility. Number four is an outpatient clinic. Now, I know all of us and all of you have always wanted to work into an outpatient clinic. Okay, outpatient clinic is you get to do so many more exercises. You deal with total hips, total knees, total shoulders, hands, elbows, ankles, feet, neck, back, core, posture, balance, vestibular, neuromuscular, musculoskeletal. You deal with a lot of things there, even functional maintenance programs, where you're basically showing a patient posture, sitting posture, body mechanics, lifting, pulling, pushing, picking up, how to work in their facility of where they're at when they're injury. You work with workman's comp. Like, there's a lot of things you can do in an outpatient facility, and this one is the most demanding, and this setting is where you need to do a lot of your homework too, because this setting is pretty demanding to work your skills and to understand what you know, and sometimes you actually learn on the job. You do a lot of taping. You do a lot of manual therapy. You do a lot of things like that that are really hands-on and really conducive to the patient. And it's, you know, you get really creative on what to do with patients. And also now they're starting to treat TMJ in some settings. So yeah, you never thought that physical therapy would go to, anybody from physical therapy would go to, a patient would go to physical therapy for TMJ, right? A little interesting. But yeah, outpatient, number four. Number five is the school setting. Now this one, I don't know too much on because I haven't worked in the school setting, but from what I've been researching and reading on, this setting is actually something where you actually have a kid that comes into you and they have a school exercise program or independent exercise program, and you teach them things, you know, there's body mechanics, there's teaching things of just functional things for them if they had an injury, or just some simple activity to keep them busy that helps them. But don't quote me on it. I should do more research on it. Okay, number six is a wellness, sports injury prevention, or just functional activity wellness. So in this setting, you're basically teaching a patient on functional activity and sports injury, so that way they can prevent, if they happen to get an injury of whatever sport they're doing or whatever daily activity they're doing, that actually if they get receive an injury, it's not going to be as bad as if they were not prepared with some of the exercises. So that can go from a range of neck, back, shoulders, knees, hips, feet, ankles, so they can actually get back to their activity. And this is a little bit more intensive, that you're dealing with athletes, you're dealing with people that are weekend warriors, you're dealing with people that are doing marathons, triathlons, school activities, their school sports, collegiate sports. And it's kind of like a maintenance program or a injury prevention program and functional activity program to maintain their stability, maintain their functionality, so that way they can be strong enough and to be prepared if they happen to receive an injury in sports. So that's number six, sports injury prevention or functional wellness. And you, this actually can work in a gym or fitness center for those of us PTAs. So you have to look into that too to see what is offered there and who offers that to PTAs to actually provide that service for patients. Okay.
Okay.
Number seven is home healthcare. Now in this setting, you're basically going to the patient's home. This is where you actually see how they move about their home, seeing what's functional, toilet transfers, shower transfers, car transfers, whenever they have to go for an outing in the community or a doctor's appointment or anything like that. And also seeing how they get in for bed, get in and out of bed for functional mobility, because it's so primal for them to be able to get out of bed, and also to educate the family or the caregivers that are there that actually will help them with throughout the day, 24 hours. Sometimes they'll have nurses there, they have a different caregiver there that actually helps them out to perform their duties, medications and things like that. So home health care, that's a good one. Okay, next one, hospice. Now hospice, that's kind of the end of life setting or maintenance kind of thing, you know, for people that are kind of at the end stage of certain things. And that one requires a lot of comfort, a lot of empathy, and a lot of just being a caregiver and even just holding the patient's hand, you know, that could complete as therapy. You know, even just simply trying to get them out of bed and get to the toilet and certain things that they'd no longer have the strength to actually do and to perform, it actually helps. So hospice, that's another one. All right, next one, industrial or warehouse or different kind of workplace. Now in this setting, you can actually work and teach the workers or the employees about body mechanics, about lifting properly, moving around things, ergonomically friendly type of sitting, type of standing, walking, when it comes to standing up. And this actually just goes to to help and educate employees on how to maintain their body so that way their body doesn't fatigue, and so that way it prevents and it minimizes injury. So yeah, industrial and the workplace or warehouses, okay? Okay, the next one, local, state, or federal government. Now, this could be working in the prison, this could be working in a behavioral health hospital, or this could be simply working with the federal government of things, so such as DOC, your state hospitals that deal with mental health and mental illnesses and behavioral health. These type of things, they're federally owned, governmently owned, state owned, locally owned, and locally ran, I should say, or federal or state ran and government ran, that you could work in the workplace. And they have physical therapy, they have recreational therapy when it comes to that too. And basically it's maintaining program, making sure the patients are functional, making sure that they're maintaining protocols and things. Sometimes there's times where they get hurt or they require surgery and they require to have physical therapy. So then it comes down to strengthening, functional mobility, posture, balance, strength, and everyday activities of daily living. Okay, so that's local, state, and federal. All right, finally, research. In this setting, do your research. I'm just joking. Research in these facilities, they actually check the validity of special tests that certain therapists will do for so many diagnoses, so many other diagnoses, so many illnesses that physical therapy could treat, and see how we could treat in the fields, and see how new studies are being shown with validity of certain back injuries, neck injuries, shoulders, knees, hips, ankles, and you know, things of that nature, and new studies of coming up to what could be used to actually treat patients. Okay, so that's a good setting there for that to be done, and that's research. Okay, so guys, I hope this really helped you guys with understanding and knowing what kind of settings are out there. Don't think that all you have to do is work in a hospital, an outpatient, or skilled nursing or home. There are so many other facilities that you can work in and so many settings that you can work in. It all just depends on how and where you want to go and how long you want to do the career. Okay, so keep in mind on what you want to do, what your skills are, and what skills you will need to practice and what skills you will need to acquire in order to treat the general public when it comes to the settings that I have touched bases on. Okay, so also, guys, do your research, see what settings work for you, see what settings are out there. Maybe one of you guys will make a new setting. Okay, well, that's all I got to say. It's Jam TJ here with All Work No Play, and please be safe out here, guys. The coronavirus, it's minimizing, okay? We're almost there, guys. We just have to be safe and stick with what we are doing, and I hope we're creating. I hope we're still being functional, and I hope we're still out there maintaining, okay? Stabilize before you mobilize. I'll catch you on the next one. Let's get to work.